يقنت منكن لله ورسوله وتعمل صالحا نؤتها أجرها مرتين وأعتدنا لها رزقا كريما.
يقنت منكن لله ورسوله وتعمل صالحا نؤتها أجرها مرتين وأعتدنا لها رزقا كريما.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. All praise be to Allah, Almighty and glory and peace be upon His beloved Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Brothers and sisters, dear viewers, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to this series of Pioneer Women in Islam. And today, inshaAllah, we will continue the great story of this Ummu Salama, the great story of this mother of the believers, the great story of the wife of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ummu Salama, after we spoke in the previous episode about her life and about her sacrifice to Islam from the beginning, and what she gave for the sake of Allah and for the sake of Islam and for the sake of this deen, and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed her that later on, after she lost her husband, who is to be a companion of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and a martyr who died in one of the expeditions, and a martyr who died in the path of Allah Almighty, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala replaced her with a better husband, and that's the Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When the Prophet alayhi salatu wasallam heard that Abu Bakr and Umar asked for her hand, and she said, "Who is there better than Abu Salama?" Abu Salama was a great companion, and Abu Salama was a great man, and was a great husband, and Ummu Salama was so attached to him. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Allah will send you someone better. How about you be my wife and I be your husband?" And then she said, "Oh Messenger of Allah, I'm a woman with a lot of jealousy. I'm scared that you see this character in me and then you turn away from me." So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to her, "Allah will take your jealousy away from you." And then she said, "Oh Messenger of Allah, I have children." So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, from his generosity, he said, "Your children are my children. Your children are my children." And now a journey of Ummu Salama from being a companion of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, now to be a companion and a wife and a mother of the believers. A wife of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and a mother of the believers. And this is a beautiful journey for us to know about the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the household of the Prophet alaihi salatu wasallam. And Ummu Salama is one of those mothers of the believers, one of the wives of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, that narrated a lot of ahadith, in particular about the household of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And inside his house, as Muslims and as the companions, they used to see the lifestyle of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam outside his house. But not many people know what's inside his house except his family. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed us with mothers of the believers, the wives of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. They used to tell us about the lifestyle of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam in his house. As an ordinary person spends at least a third of their life inside their house, if not more. And that's why Allah blessed us with such mothers of the believers like Aisha, like Ummu Salama, like Safiya, like Hafsa, who tells us more about the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam and his life inside his house. Ummu Salama radiallahu ta'ala anha was amongst those who the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam loved so much. And she was a wise woman. She used to be a very wise woman, a very wise believer. That the wives of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to get jealous from her sometimes. They used to get jealous from her because they used to see how much the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to respect Ummu Salama and honor her. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to respect her and honor her, and honor her wisdom, and he used to honor the way she used to think. And the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasallam praised her in some of the ahadith, where it's been narrated that Ummu Salama was once in the household of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasallam with her daughter. And at that moment, Al-Hasan and Al-Husayn and Fatima will walk into the house of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasallam. So the Prophet alayhi salatu wasallam will put Al-Hasan and Al-Husayn and Fatima on one side, and he says sallallahu alayhi wasallam, "Rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu alaykum ahlal bayt, innahu hamidun majid." May the mercy of Allah and the blessings of Allah be upon you, ahlal bayt, the family of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasallam. "Innahu hamidun majid." Allah azza wa jalla is almighty and all glory and the one to be praised. So Ummu Salama got jealous and she started to cry. So the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said to Umm Salama, why are you weeping and crying? So she said, oh Messenger of Allah, what about us? You gave them the specialty of them being from your family and you left us alone. So the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, you and your daughter are from my family. Allahu Akbar. You and your daughter are from my family, the family of the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam. And because of her, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed some verses in the Holy Quran. She said to the Messenger of Allah one day, oh Messenger of Allah, why we don't hear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioning females much in the Quran Kareem? Why aren't females mentioned in the Quran Kareem much as the men? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He sent a verse, إِنَّ الْمُسْلِمِينَ وَالْمُسْلِمَاتِ وَالْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ وَالْقَانِتِينَ وَالْقَانِتَاتِ. In Surah Al-Ahzab, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, the believing male and the believing female, the believing men and the believing women, the Muslim men and the Muslim women, the God-fearing men and the God-fearing women, those who fast from the men and those who fast from the women, those who donate from the men and those who donate from the female or the woman. In Arabic, when you say mu'min, you refer to a male or a female. And when you say it in plural, you refer to a male or female. So when Allah says al-mu'mineen, it's also men and women. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted to mention the female in particularly. Allah azza wa jalla wanted to mention the woman in particularly in the Qur'an al-Kareem as a request of Umm Salama. When she said to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, why doesn't Allah constantly mention the female? So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the believing men and the believing women, the believing Muslim, the Muslim men and the Muslim women, the fasting men and the fasting women, those who donate from the men and those who donate from the women, the God-fearing men and the God-fearing women, the pious men and the pious women. This is because of Umm Salama and her question. And not only that, but she said to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, why doesn't Allah azza wa jalla mention the female? Why doesn't Allah Azza wa Jalla mention the women when He speaks about the hijrah, about the great migration from Mecca to Medina? Why aren't the women mentioned when they sacrifice? And Umm Salama is from amongst those who sacrificed a lot for the sake of Allah. So because of this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He reveals in Surah Ali Imran, فَاسْتَجَابَ لَهُمْ رَبُّهُمْ أَنِّي لَا أُضِيعَ عَمَلَ عَامِلٍ مِّنْكُمْ مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أُنْثَى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, Allah replied back to the believers. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, and I would never ever let a good deed of a male or a female believer who done a good deed to be lost. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, I would never ever mislose or I would never ever make a good deed of a male believer or a female believer to be lost. This is as a response to, and a response to Umm Salama and what she requested from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And she was from amongst those who had a lot of wisdom that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to consult. When the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam, during the Sulh al-Hudaybiyah, the Hudaybiyah treaty, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came out of Medina traveling with thousands of his companions to Mecca with the intention to perform Umrah. But the people of Quraysh did not allow and permit the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam to enter Mecca. Therefore, they decided to sign a treaty between them and the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam. When the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam agreed on the treaty, the companions found it a bit hard to accept at that moment. So the Prophet alayhi salatu wa sallam came out and commanded everyone to slaughter their sacrifice and to shave their hair, as it is the end of the journey of Umrah and for us to return the following year. When the Prophet ﷺ commanded the companions were waiting. Maybe something will change. Maybe the Prophet ﷺ will change his decision. Maybe Allah will send to the Prophet ﷺ a verse where He'll turn him around from his decision. So none of the companions got up and shaved their hair and slaughtered their sacrifice. So the Prophet ﷺ saw the reaction of the companions not obeying him. So he went into his tent and he had with his company on this journey Umm Salama radiallahu ta'ala anha. When the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam was so angry and he said, how would Allah azza wa jal give victory to a nation when they disobey their Prophet? So Umm Salama said, oh Messenger of Allah, calm down. Umm Salama, the wife of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, is the one that's calming the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam now. She is the one that's giving the advice to the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. And she said, oh Messenger of Allah, calm down. These companions, you have to understand, they're a bit cut and hurt in their hearts. They came all the way from Medina thinking they're going to perform Umrah and see the Kaaba. It's not going to be easy for them to take and just swallow in one moment. Maybe if you yourself walk out and shave your hair and you yourself slaughter with your own hands and they see the action with their own eyes, then they know that this decision, there's no turning back on it. So the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ walked out of his tent. and he shaved his hair. And sallallahu alayhi wa sallam slaughtered his sacrifice. When the companions saw that, they all rushed and followed the path of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam and his action. Who was the reason from behind that? Ummu Salama. Ummu Salama from her wisdom. Ummu Salama radiallahu ta'ala anha from her wisdom. She's the one that gave the advice to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam. And this is the wisdom that Allah chose Ummu Salama to be in the company of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam during that journey. If it was another wife, maybe she would not have that wisdom that Ummu Salama radiallahu ta'ala anha had. She was the one with a lot of wisdom. And she is the one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed verses because of her questioning to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam. And she was with the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam during his life and until his death, and even she continued to stay alive after his death sallallahu alayhi wasalam. And she narrated many narrations about the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and she narrated of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam many traditions and statements, that she has a collection of 380 hadith being narrated by Ummu Salama. And these are hadith in particularly talking about the household of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, and talking about what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam used to do in his house. Because of her, we have 380 hadith. Because of her, we have 380 noble hadith of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, to know more of the actions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasalam. And she stayed alive even during the time of Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and Umar ibn al-Khattab, and Uthman, and even during the time of Ali. And the Khulafa used to consult her and ask her. The Khulafa used to consult her and ask her and turn back to her when they needed an advice, because she was that wise woman with wise advice radiallahu ta'ala anha. And she was during the time of Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and that dispute and misunderstanding, I prefer to call it misunderstanding, between Aisha and Ali. And when Aisha wanted to travel towards Ali during the battle of Mawqi'at al-Jamal, Ummu Salama radiallahu ta'ala anha advised Aisha not to travel. She advised Aisha not to continue disputing with Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu. She advised Aisha not to continue doing what she is doing. And Aisha, she said, "Oh Ummu Salama, I respect your advice. And you are the one to be, you are the one that has the right to give an advice. But I know more in this situation than anyone else." But later on, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha turned back on what she was deciding to do, and she wished she should have taken the advice of Ummu Salama. Ummu Salama is that wise woman. Ummu Salama is that wise companion. Ummu Salama is that wise wife of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. She passed away 61 hijrah, 61 years after the hijrah, and she was 84 years old. 84 years old, and she was buried in Al-Baqi', not far away from her husband sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Al-Baqi', which is near the mosque of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and near the grave of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasallam. Ummu Salama radiallahu ta'ala anha, a symbol of sacrifice. Ummu Salama radiallahu ta'ala anha, a symbol of wisdom. Ummu Salama radiallahu ta'ala anha, a symbol of piety. Ummu Salama radiallahu ta'ala anha, a symbol of righteousness. When you talk about Ummu Salama, you think of great sacrifice. When you talk about Ummu Salama, you think of wisdom. When you talk about Ummu Salama, you think of piety. When you talk about Ummu Salama, you think of righteousness. Ummu Salama radiallahu ta'ala anha, she is the one that she was firm with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam before she was a wife to him, and she was firm with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam after she was a wife to him. She supported him before she was a wife to him sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and she continued to support him after she was a wife to him. Ummu Salama radiallahu ta'ala anha, she is a great example to the men, a great example of her sacrifice to the men, a great example of her wisdom to the men, a great example of her smartness to the men, a great example of her piety to the men and the women, radiallahu ta'ala anha wa ardaha. This is the story of Ummu Salama, a story no doubt to be told. Be with us on more on great and pioneer women in Islam in other episodes. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi وبركاته.
ومن يقنت منكن لله ورسوله وتعمل صالحا نؤتها أجرها مرتين وأعتدنا لها رزقا كريما.
ومن يقنت منكن لله ورسوله وتعمل صالحا نؤتها أجرها مرتين نؤتها أجرها مرتين وأعتدنا لها رزقا كريما
إن كن لله ورسوله وتعمل صالحا نؤتها أجرها مرتين وأعتدنا لها رزقا كريما